Good evening, Muhammad. I'm Amajal Knowles with your Sunday Sports. Well, in the aftermath of Hurricane Dorian, the relief efforts were certainly heard by the global sporting arena as donations continue to pour in from teams and athletes alike. The NFL organization, with undoubtedly the biggest ties to the 242, certainly doing their part to help rebuild the Bahamas. Miami Dolphins announcing via their social media their plans to help. Now the aftermath and damage of Hurricane Dorian is now apparent. Now with today's game against the Baltimore Ravens and next week against the New England Patriots, Hard Rock Stadium will have six separate drop-off locations for items such as flashlights, batteries, diapers, and feminine hygiene products that will be transported to the affected islands. Also doing his part to assist his former Dolphins great and Hall of Famer defensive end Jason Taylor, he announced via his Instagram page that he was en route to his second home, the Bahamas. Via a boat, Taylor could be seen transporting items including chainsaws, tarps, generators, water, food, flashlights, batteries, and clothes. The gesture by Taylor and the Dolphins show that the relationship between the team and the Bahamas' loyal Finns fan base is as strong as ever. And another team from the 305 also keeping the Bahamas in their hearts and on their minds, literally, as the University of Miami Hurricanes donning Bahamian flag stickers on their helmets last night in their ACC opener against the University of North Carolina. Another strong team fan connection due to the country's proximity to Florida, the number of Bahamian students enrolled at the university. Via its social media, the Hurricanes posting a link to its Hurricane Dorian Response Fund, where through medical and humanitarian efforts, the university said it is committed to helping those in the Bahamas and other impacted regions along the Atlantic coast. Still in Florida, one of the Bahamas' own upcoming baseball stars doing his part to spread awareness and garner support. Shortstop prospect in the Miami Marlins organization, Jazz Chisholm, posting this PSA on his social media for fans and persons at large that want to know how they would be able to help out.
Jazz Chisholm here. As you know, the Bahamas is a place I call home. It's always been a special part of my life. During this time of need after Hurricane Dorian, I want to thank the Marlins for all their support and asking every one of you to help contribute towards the relief. For all of you who can help, starting today and for the next 7 days, you can bring donated tents, cots, waters, and supplies directly to Marlins Park. I'll be there in person on Tuesday to donate and see you all. Every donation can make a difference. Thank you for your support.
Lou Rawls' Tum Tum Nairn is headed back to Michigan State. Coach Tom Izzo announcing via a news release that his former point guard and three-time captain, who helped lead the Spartans to the 2015 Final Four, will join his staff as a graduate manager this fall. Nairn, who graduated from MSU in 2018 with a degree in communications, spent last season as a player development assistant with the NBA's Phoenix Suns. With the Suns, Nairn helped coach Igor Kokoskov work with the team's youngsters. They included Josh Jackson, Mikhail Bridges, and fellow Bahamian DeAndre Ayton, many of whom were his peers on the court, where he played at Michigan State from 2014 to 2018. As a freshman, he started the final 16 games in the Spartans' surprising run to the 2015 Final Four, where they ultimately lost to Duke in the national semifinal. In soccer news, with the big showdown against Bonaire in the CONCACAF League of Nations, players donning the 242 on their jersey are expecting to have a big performance in tomorrow's game.
My expectations, I'd say they're a bit high just because of the competition. Well, we are currently in Group C, so we're a bit of a lower-ranked team. So we're looking at Bonaire, who's ranked in the bottom third along with us and a lot of other teams like Turks and Caicos. So it's going to be a good competition, you know what I mean? So we're looking to come out on top at the end of the day. So I think once we put in the effort and we play for each other and we fight to the end, I think we should come out victorious.
I think that we definitely narrowed down within those 2 months of how we want to play and what we're expecting from players tactically, shape, position, how we're going to defend, how we're going to attack, how we're going to press. And we did most of that work. So as long as the players are staying in shape and training, they'll come back a week before the match. We'll do 2-a-days and we're going to be very well prepared. We're going to win this group. We have to win the group. Yeah, done.
In bodybuilding news, last week's Nationals saw several prospects try and put their names on the map and use the platform to elevate themselves, while there were others who were simply trying to continue their journey in securing that illustrious pro card. And we caught up with a pair of athletes who updated us on their progress.
Well, the show went exceptionally well. I had a blast in Aruba. That was my first time ever competing in Aruba. I got to compete against some fantastic athletes. I got to get some good critiques from the judges as well on my performance, on my appearance, and it was pretty good. And I hope to go back to compete again in Aruba, maybe next year, God's better life. And hopefully it goes well as planned, that's how I wanted to go.
In terms of the journey, it's good to see the progress that I'm making year over year. And that's part of the motivation to see what improvements you can make from one year to the next and go to the competition and see this basically the same judges, and they judge you according to your improvements and according to the competition at the show. So right now things are going good. I'm looking forward to the CAC competition this year in Dominican Republic. Next Pro Card qualifier, hopefully get it there.
Now, as for the struggle of staying consistent after failing to get to the top.
All I can do is take the judges' critiques, the audience critiques, and go back to the drawing board, work on what I need to work on, and just take it from there. All I'm going to do is use it to motivate me, continue to train hard, listen to my coach, diet right, condition my body right, and just be prepared for next year.
Just loving the sport, being healthy, being fit, at the age of 43, now going on 44, seeing what this body could do up to age of 99, seeing how long I could keep this body in shape, and hopefully just motivating the younger guys who are coming up to look at somebody at my age and say, okay, he's much older than I am, and he's doing it, and he's continuing to do it, and he's doing well at it. So just motivating them to continue to come up in the sport, and seeing that no matter how old you are, your body can still be as young as a 20-year-old.
And that's been a look at sports on this Sunday. A quick check on weather is up next.